Around the World in 80 Days. Phileas Fogg was a rich man. He lived in London with his newly employed French valet, Passepartout. Fogg was also a member of the Reform Club. One day, at the Reform Club, the members were talking about a recent bank robbery. A discussion took place about how the world had grown smaller and that the robber could be anywhere in the world. In fact, Fogg claimed that he could travel around the world in 80 days. Even a wager of £20,000 was made on that. Fogg said, "Today is Wednesday, the 2nd of October. I shall travel around the world and be back in London, in this very room of the Reform Club, on Saturday, the 21st of December. Fogg and Passepartout then left London for Paris via train. First, Fogg and Passepartout went to the Swiss Canal to get Fogg's visa stamped. There, a detective named Fix got suspicious about Fogg. Fix was dispatched from London in search of a bank robber. He mistook Fogg to be the robber, as the description of the robber as well as the timing and place of departure match with those of Fogg. So, Fix decided to follow him. Since Fix didn't have a warrant to arrest Fogg, he followed Fogg and Passepartout on a steamer to Bombay, India. They reached Bombay 2 days before schedule. Fix then went to the police station to get an arrest warrant in order to catch Fogg, but he could not get it. On the other hand, Fogg decided to board a train to Calcutta. While he waited for the train, Passepartout wandered in the city and entered a temple wearing his shoes. There, he narrowly escaped the angry priest. Finally, Fogg and Passepartout got into the Great Indian Peninsula Railway from Bombay to Calcutta by train. But the train stopped midway, as 50 miles of the track was not yet complete. So, they bought an elephant to ride up to Allahabad, from where they could travel in a train to Calcutta. They also hired a Parsi guide to lead them. On the way, Fogg and Passepartout saved a young woman named Orda from being burnt on her husband's pyre. Feeling that it would not be safe for her to remain in India, Fogg decided to take her with them. Upon reaching Calcutta, Fix got Passepartout arrested on account of entering the temple wearing his shoes. Fogg bailed him out and they travelled from Calcutta to Hong Kong in a steamer. Frustrated, Fix too followed them to Hong Kong. Due to bad weather, the steamer was 24 hours behind its schedule. Thankfully, the steamer, which would take them to Yokohama, Japan, was to leave at 5 next morning. But next morning, Fogg could not find Passepartout, and the steamer sailed without them. Fogg hired a boat to take them to Shanghai, where he hoped to catch the steamer. Fogg and Erda reached Shanghai just in time to catch the steamer, as it was pulling out of the harbor. Meanwhile, Passepartout, being under the effect of opium given to him by Fix, had become unconscious. He couldn't inform his master of the early departure of the steamer. Somehow, he himself had boarded it. In the absence of Passepartout, Fogg hired Fix for £200 to assist them. After reaching Yokohama, they went out in search of Passepartout. Reunited, Fogg and the company took a steamer from Yokohama to San Francisco, which would take 21 days. On the ninth day, after leaving Yokohama, Fogg had traveled exactly one half of the terrestrial globe. He had exhausted 52 of the 80 days in which he was to complete the tour. When Fogg reached San Francisco, he was neither behind nor ahead of his schedule. From there, they took a train for New York. The train started off at full speed, but was delayed due to a huge herd of buffaloes crossing the track, a broken bridge, and an attack by a band of Sioux. By the time Fogg and his company reached New York, the steamer to Liverpool, England, had already left. Fogg paid the captain of a cargo ship to take them to the destination they were going. But then he bribed a crew member and got the ship turned towards Liverpool. Fogg and his company made it to Queenstown, Ireland, where they took a train to Dublin. From there, wasting no time, they took a steamer, and at last, Fogg, along with Fix, Passepartout, and Other, disembarked at the Liverpool dock. As soon as Fogg and his company reached English territory, Fix arrested Fogg. But when he came to know that the real robber had been arrested already, Fix released him. Fogg, Other, and Passepartout took an express train to get to London. Fogg realized that after having made the tour of the world, he had lost the wager. According to him, it was Sunday. He had to reach a day earlier. Upon reaching home, Fogg decided to marry Other the next day, Monday. But he came to know from the priest that the next day was Sunday. Because Fogg had travelled eastwards, they had gained a day on crossing the international date line. Fogg rushed to the Reform Club and reached just in time to win the wager. He had travelled around the world in 80 days. Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.